everyone, and welcome back to my channel for another video here today. And today's a little special. It's one of my videos with The Sims 4 Create a Sim Demo, and I know this is a little late. It came out like last week. I got it the first day, I guess. It's by invite only. It's just random. I just got randomly picked. It's nothing special. I just got randomly picked, and I saw it in my Origin account under my games, and I screamed for like 5 minutes. I was so freaking excited. You guys wouldn't believe it. It was crazy. And I just wanted, there's a lot of videos of The Sims 4 Create a Sim Demo out, but I just wanted to do one kind of on the perspective of a Sims 2 player and not particularly a Sims 3 player. I mean, I play The Sims 3, I've played it before, but I don't think it's as in-depth as The Sims 2 was and how it is still is. And I just wanted to give you guys my opinion on what I thought, and yeah, based on Sims 2 player's perspective. That's how I'm gonna go with this video. Okay, and whenever I see a new game, I always wanna know what the game options are, because I think that's the most interesting part, not gonna lie. So these are all the displays. Resolution, that's my resolution. Refresh rate, vertical sync, I have no idea what that is. So, my graphics are on ultra, and I have a pretty okay computer. I mean, it's pretty new, I guess, sort of. It's custom built. It's not the best, I mean, but it's better than like a laptop or whatever, because it is a desktop. But you can find my computer specifications on my main YouTube page under the About Me tab, or the About tab. It should be there. Just scroll down a little bit. And then, so ultra and low medium, like that's really cool. But mine's on ultra. And these are those. So yeah, and then audio, I hope it's not too loud. I turned it like way down because I tried to record this earlier and it was way, way, way too loud. And yeah, and I don't know what these really mean. I mean, I'm not really with the stereo. I'm not really well educated with the audio settings and what they should be and whatnot. But yeah, audio quality, you can go totally offline. Like you can just be totally offline and stuff if you don't want to be online all the time. But for the demo, you do need to have an internet connection to download it off of Origin, which, I don't know, it's kind of a hassle, but, you know, whatever. I'm fine with it. And then this goes to a different website I'm not going to go to. And there's also lessons, which are really, really cool. Like, you have all these lessons that are, like, super, super cool. Like, look at all those Sims. It's so cute. And their relationships. Okay. So I guess we can just get started and into the game and whatnot. Oh, and this is the gallery. Let me show the gallery first, okay? So there's currently 208 players currently online. I think that's really cool because, oh my god, once The Sims 4 comes out, there's going to be like a million, maybe not a million, but like a big number here. And that's going to be so cool to see, like, oh, today there's not as many people on. I wonder why. Oh, it's because the World Cup's on or something. I don't know, but I just think that's funny. That's how many households are in the gallery, and we just got the demo. And these are notifications from people you follow. And so, yeah, I'm following Everything Isaac, friend of Andrew Arcade. Andrew Arcade, and then that's a sim I made and such. So this is the community. You can just click any sim you want. Like if I want to click this sim, I just go, oh, I like this sim. You can favorite it and then save it to my library. And then, oh, I'm not even in created a sim yet. But this is my library, and these six sims come right away. They're just already downloaded. And then all your downloaded sims will come right here. You don't have to download them. You can just put them into your create a sim thing down there, and then you don't even have to download them, but then you can after to get them later. And this is a sim I made, Emily Wright. And then this is my sim self and my brother. I don't think it really looks like me, but my brother looks a lot like himself. Like, I'm not gonna lie. It's pretty funny. Okay, and then this is also a pair of sims I made. They were just brother and sister. And then this is a sim that was made by SimGuru. That was made by SimGuru. All these were in Belagoth, of course. And I want to show you, there's also the most downloads of all time. And Belagoth has been downloaded 1,151 times. That is a lot of times. So it like shows up, and that was probably a bug, I'm pretty sure. And yeah, so I don't even know what to say about that. I actually did download that sim because I just thought it was really funny. I'm sorry, okay. I'm getting preoccupied. Okay, let's head into the create a sim. So once you start, there's you can start over right here. It won't randomize. It won't have random sim. It'll just have one of like the sims we've already seen and stuff. It'll like, I think there's a hidden library where it has all these sims.
Yes, and such.
I just think she's so cute. Like your little nose. I think she's a really cute sim. And of course you can change gender, so you can, and they do have the same like facial structure. So like in The Sims 2, I know if I'm too lazy to make a male sim, I'll just take a female sim and then just convert her to a male, and I'm like, oh, that works. That was way faster than what it could have been. And you can only have young adult in the demo, which I'm totally fine with. I mean, I don't really care that much. I mean, some people are like, oh my gosh, why didn't they put teenagers in the demo?
Oh.
And I'm just like, just at least they gave out a demo, like, I don't know. And then here are all the walk styles. I'm sure you've already seen these, but I just think they're so cute.
Dag.
I think the only ones I would really use is maybe probably the feminine walk, the default one.
Oh.
And maybe that one. Possibly, but I'm not sure. And then you can, of course, change the voice. So they're different for male and female, but for female, it's sweet, melodic, and lilted. And I like lilted because it's like really sexy and stuff.
The Vaz Febine.
Yeah.
Me Boon.
Yeah.
Onea Leray.
Yeah, well, I just think that's really cute and stuff. Okay, and then I love everything can be pretty much everything can be randomized except the traits, and I really wish the traits could be randomized so then I can have a little diversity and I don't just pick the same traits. But I guess I can just do that with dice anyways, like you do for The Sims 2, of course. I guess it's not a big deal, but I would love if they could add a randomizer for the traits so I don't have to get out dice and whatnot. And so yeah, pretty much like if you like this last name but you don't like the first name, you can just change that. And if you like the first name but you don't like the last name, you can just change that. So Angela Gray. This is Angela Gray, you guys. Okay, and then like in The Sims 3, if you guys really, I don't know. I don't think a lot of you watching are going to be Sims 3 players, but if you are, you know that only the, like, you can't randomize them separately. You had to randomize the full name, not separate ones and such. So that's really handy. And also this, oh my god, I love this so much. So if you don't like your body shape, you can just randomize the body shape. So that's a new body shape. And it's really awesome. Like, and if you don't like her skin tone, you can just randomize her skin tone to whatever you want. And if you don't like her face, you can just randomize her face and it'll change her face and whatnot. And I think this is so handy, like, oh my god. And you can just randomize her hair into whatever you want. So let's just get a, and their voice even. So if you watch that up there, it'll just change it.
Hum, boom, in a bosh.
And it'll also change into each different one.
Amigable.
So you can, and also the clothing. I feel like I'm just rambling now. But Kayla's got a whole randomized sim. See, look how cute she looks. I think the randomization in this game is really, really good. Like, I think they did a really good job with the whole randomizing and keeping the clothes kind of matchy. I mean, those are kind of two different shades, but it still works. I think it still works. Of course, you can turn them. I really wish they're, I don't know. Some people complain that there's no mirror. Like, that's essential in Sims game, but I kind of like without the mirror. Because you can just turn around really fast anyway, so what's the really the point, I guess. But, yeah. Okay. And then, Okay. It's a little tricky to get used to at first because it's kind of touchy, and because it's so fast that it's really touchy and sensitive to what you do and stuff. So body, they have all these preset body types, and I think they are great and awesome. Like, oh my god. I just think they're really cool. And there's a lot of diversity, excuse me, of skin tones, and I really, really like that, and I think that is so cool. And this pale, though, it, like, blinds me. I'm not kidding. If you can see my screen right now, I'm like, oh my god. Okay. And they're like, I think some people I've been seeing on Tumblr that they don't really like. They think the skin tone looks really flat and low resolution, but I think they're really, really pretty and detailed and stuff. I don't know. Maybe they're just a little matte, and that's kind of how the cartoonish style is supposed to be, but, you know, there's CC. Just get over it, please, because I think it looks really, really good. If I was you. And they also have a blue and a green skin tone. Oops, that's not green. And green. Which I think is cool. Okay, and then there's all these different base ones that are different ethnicities. And I believe that, so there is a limit to how much you can move it, and it's when it turns red like that, that's the farthest you can move it. And I think there's different limitations for each, like, ethnicity, so you kind of have to try around if you want, like, the biggest eyes, because that's the biggest eyes you can have. But if you go to those ones, maybe it is the same. I'm not really sure. So, yeah. But anyways, yeah. I just think the eyes are really cute, too. And I love, like, the eye, I don't know how you say, textures. Not really textures, but you know what I'm talking about when you get custom eyes and stuff. But I think these look really, really good. Like, I feel like this could be a game that I wouldn't need CC to play. Like, I wouldn't absolutely have to have it where I could not play it. I don't know. That's just me, though. And I just think it's a really, really pretty game. But some people don't think so. But I think it's really good. And I really love it. And oh my god, these freckles are adorable. They're so cute. Especially these ones, like, these are adorable. And they have moles, of course, which I always think moles are kind of freaky when they're, like, right on the lip. Because, I don't know, like, Marilyn Monroe style, and I don't know, it just kind of freaks me out. I don't know why, just, yeah. And I really love all these hair color options. Except this one. Wait, not this one. This one. I just really don't like this yellow, or this blonde color. I don't know why. it just really scares me. So then your Sims would have to be like this blonde or like bleach blonde, which I don't know. But I really don't like this blonde color. I don't know why, I just really don't. But otherwise, I like all these other tones pretty well. Like this is a brownish red, which I think is so cute. Or reddish brown. Oh my god, I think it's so adorable. And now in The Sims 4, everything is separated into separate categories, so you won't have to load a long list if you're just looking for short hair. You can just go that, so you don't have to load up this whole page. And also, you can just remove everything just by clicking a button, so you don't have to go through and load everything and then find it and then remove it. It literally, it takes such a short amount of time to make Sims. It's amazing. Like, that's all I have to say. It's just, this is Miley Cyrus hair. That's all I'm saying. Yep. Okay. Or this. Or maybe this. Let's be honest, okay? I just think all these things are just so cute. Oh my god. I think all these hairs are adorable. Like, literally. Like, look at those braids. They're so well detailed. And I know some people don't like the hair. They think it's too clay-like. But Sims are clay, guys. Sims are pixels. That's how Sims are. And I'm sure there'll be CC hair. Like, as soon as the game comes out, someone's gonna be like, already got a default, or already got some custom hair, and then everyone's gonna be on that train, and you don't have to worry about anything, because it'll be fine. But I really love it. I really, really, really do. And of course, hats go on any type of hair. Like, oh my god, look how cute this is. Oh my god. It's so cute. Like, look at that. Like, she's about ready to go to camp. Not really camp. I really like these hats, too. I think they're super adorable. And I'm gonna put this hat on her just because it's really cute. And adorable. And I really like all these color options. I mean, there are great color options. There's a lot of color options. And I really, really like that. And then you can also separate them into brimmed or baseball caps. So that's cool. And then also accessories, which are earrings, glasses, and necklaces. So let's get some earrings on her. See, they have lots of studs, which I like that. Like different kinds of studs. Because usually you only have like the one pair of studs that you always, always use. Which for me will probably be these ones because I love just classic studs. Actually, I have some in right now. Just like that. A little smaller, but just like that. And these glasses. I'm not too fond of the glasses. I never really was fond of any glasses. I mean, I never really put these ones are decent if they're in a darker color. But I don't know. I've never really been fond of glasses in The Sims. I mean, look at that. Yeah. But these ones are kind of cute. If they're a little bit smaller, just to like right across there, I think they'd be super cute. But I know that's not the style of these type of glasses, but I still think they're pretty cute anyways. And then necklaces, there's not a lot of necklaces. Not like, I wish they were just like a plain chain necklace, like just a regular everyday necklace, but these are just kind of fancier ones, but I'm okay with that. And then this one. That one's okay, but yeah. And then the makeup. I really like the makeup. There's a lot of options. So you can separate into eyes, eyeliner, cheeks, and lips. And eyes. I think this first one's my favorite because it's the most everyday-esque ones. Here, let me do something quick. I just want to pull her eye in a little bit. I know that's not really ethnic, true ethnicity, but I'm gonna deal with it because it's my sim. Just for the make. And yeah, I like the first one the most, I think, because it's the most like natural and such. Because some of these, like, there's green eyeliner. Do you see that? Like, I don't really like those, but I mean, those are for some more. This one's okay too. Yeah, that one's okay too. And then the eyeliners, I really like the eyeliners as well. I probably only put them in this black color, probably. But I really, really like these eyeliners. I think they're really cute and whatnot. I mean, they're a little overpowering. I hope they add an opacity little slider thing to lower the opacity a little bit. I think that'd be great. And then also, there's only one thing, one type of cheeks, but really, how many types of cheek things do you need? Am I right? Yeah. And then there's lipstick. There's just this normal lipstick. And then there's a gloss. And there's lots of colors. I think my favorite color is this one. On both shades. Because I just like, it's nice. It depends on what skin tone, I guess. Yeah. It just depends on what type of skin tone. Like, I kind of like this on hers because it kind of matches her red hair. Not gonna lie. And then, oh, and also, forgot to show this. Sorry about that, okay. My brother is annoying me, okay. Anyways, on to the outfits. So you can also separate them, like the tops, so you don't have to load all this stuff all at once. Jackets, t-shirts, sweaters, tanks, suit jackets, brassieres, I love that word, and vests, which of course you can get a little raunchy and whatnot. So yeah, I really like the clothing options. I think they're really great. I would have liked some more casual. Like, I don't really like these t-shirts. I don't think I'd have my sim, except maybe this, if it was in like a darker color. That actually matches our hat, not gonna lie. But I would have liked some more t-shirts and also some more dresses, because some of these dresses get really old and I wish they had more for the, like, a more classic dress instead of kind of the, not burlesque-esque, but you know what I mean. A little more tame. Like, these three are the most, well, this isn't really a dress. I don't call this a dress. Just like a long shirt, but you know, some people can call it a dress. But there's also this robe, which I think this is super cute. And then bottoms. Let me just put a shirt on her. I just like that it matches her hat, basically. And I don't know. I like the clothing options. I wish there were more like pants. There's jeans, but I don't know. I'm sure they'll, you know, they'll add more. I mean, obviously, in stuff packs and stuff. But yeah, and there's one kind of underwear, which I think is fine. I mean, how many different kinds of underwear do you really need? But I really like everything, basically. I really love these pants. I think they're adorable, but I wish there were more patterns. Of course, you can't always get what you want, but whatever. And there are also accessories. There are bracelets, gloves, rings, leggings, and socks, which I really love the leggings. I mean, you can't see them right now, but I think they're really cute. And then for shoes, there's sandals, flats, loafers, slippers, heels, wedges, sneakers, and boots, Hoops. Boots. And I'm in love with these boots that she has on right now. They're so adorable. And I think they're so, so cute. And yeah.
Ah.
I just love them. So you guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. And I really want a lot of you to rethink your choice. I'm not telling you to buy the game, but I'm just saying to rethink and go over the reasons why you don't like The Sims 4, and then things why you don't like The Sims 3, or you don't like The Sims 2, or The Sims 1, or whatever. And because I think The Sims 3, most people were just mad for the loading times, and like to load up CAS and stuff, because Creatism took forever to load and go through everything. Like the clothes for me, with having all the expansion packs and like everything, it would take like 7 minutes to load all that up, and I was just already like done with it and stuff. And yeah, so this game, I know there's no toddlers and pools, but I think we can get past that a little bit, and I know we can. And yeah, because it is a beautiful game, and I really, really love it so far, just from the Create a Sim. I just think it's pretty much amazing, and yeah. So I hope you guys have a great day, and yeah, so, yeah, goodbye.